All right, there we go. All right, welcome back, everybody, to Coffee and Art in the Morning. I'm Dee Dee, and this is like the next segment on our Monday morning show. If I have a lot of happy mail or hauls, you know, a couple of new magazines or anything like that, and it takes like an hour to go through that, I just make that a separate video before we start a project, so I have plenty of time to work on the project, especially since Miss Jean is out of town, isn't streaming, but Carrie said she might stream, so we'll put a link to, Carrie can put a link if she wants to stream after a while. Okay, so we're talking about magazine journals. I probably have, I don't know how many of these. Oh, quite a few, but I picked the two that I have that are the most completed to work in today. I was saying earlier on part one, I have a lot of, like, there's just a tiny bit of paint left in here. Now, what you can do, there's a couple things you can do with just a tiny bit of leftover acrylic craft paint. If you've just got a little bit left in it, add water to it and make it a wash. But make sure you put a big W somewhere. A big W somewhere on it saying that that indicates to you that it's a wash. Because there have been times that I've not put a W. I've popped open the lid, shook down the paint thinking it was really thick, and splattered it everywhere because it was mostly water, okay? So just a little tip there for you. If you put a little bit of water in them to make it a wash, put a W somewhere on there so you know that it's a wash. But I have some different, like, off-brand, some CraftSmart, some different ones. I was looking at my paint cart that I store most of my paints on behind me. Now, the paints I use every day are right here, right here. Okay, these are all my paints that are, like, right there. But these were on my cart, not being used. All right, sorry if that just kind of, like, freaked y'all out for a second. Let me readjust here. So I want to use these up or use them, you know, use them before they get totally dried out. You splatter. You, yes. Well, you know, here's the thing about magazine journals. All they are, and for me, I use some old, not my Somerset Studio, but Stampington and Company, the publishers of Somerset Studio and the Art Journal magazine, which, by the way, let me restate this real quick at the beginning of this one. If you don't have the new Art Journaling magazine, our Pack or Die has an article, an 8-page spread in the new Art Journaling April-May edition. Okay, so Stampington and Company publishes this, Somerset Studio, and probably about, look, this is, look how many different magazines they publish. Okay, so I have a few of those, and I still have even more. I can make tons of these. With as many magazines as I have by that company. But like the Blogger, the Apprentice, or some of the other ones, I've turned them into magazine journals. Okay, let's see, I'm not the only one here with vertigo. Don't cause any trouble, Terry. Just saying. Hi, Debbie. Okay, so in this one, I've taken two and glued the covers together to make it nice and thick. And I'll talk about this issue here in a minute. And in this one, I've taken three. So all I've done is glued the back and the front of two of them together with Eileen's Tacky Glue, covered the front, covered the backs, glued them together, and it holds up fine. I've covered them with scrapbook paper. This one happens to be a glossy scrapbook paper. And then I duct tape the spines, and then even add some decorative washi over the top of the duct tape. Now, if you do that, you're going to have to glue your washi tape. It's not going to stick to duct tape, okay? You're going to have to put glue on the duct tape, and then cover it with a decorative washi tape, if that's what you want. In this case, I just kind of match the colors, right? And there are all kinds of pretty duct tapes out there. Yeah, if y'all have any questions, hi Pam, everybody else coming in. We got almost 75 people here this morning. Thanks everybody for being here. I really appreciate it on an early Monday morning. And if you don't watch the live show, then you're probably watching this on YouTube. But it is a live show on Ustream every Monday morning at 9 a.m. Eastern Coffee and Art in the Morning, Inkwell, either one you can find me. I'm Inky Well with an I everywhere else. Facebook, well, Facebook, it's Dee Dee Willingham too. But Instagram and Twitter, I'm Inky Well with an I. So if y'all want to follow me over there. Okay, so what I want to do is talk about, these are old. I don't even know if I have a date. Hang on, guys, let me check and see if I have a date in the front of either one of these. Sometimes I date my magazine, I mean my journal. Sometimes I date the pages. Sometimes I don't date them at all because I'm working in them for years at a time. So, all right, this one's 2012. So this one's probably 2011. I'm guessing 11. This one for sure is 2012. So of course it's way before I started uploading videos to YouTube and having been streaming on Ustream for about 5.5 years. So I work in them here and there. Although, to be honest, I haven't worked in them a lot lately because I have so many other projects going on. And I try to do a variety of things here on Ustream so that you get new ideas and inspiration even from old things. Okay. So what I want to do is these are both about three-fourths of the way painted in. So I thought it'd be a good way to use up some of these paints. Plus, I got all the ones I use all the time right there. Julie says she needs to finish her second magazine journal. Yeah. Well, they're ongoing. These are the kind of things, if you don't keep a desk journal like some of the other desk journals I've shown you, this is also a good alternative to a desk journal. All right, so let me tell a few of the particulars about how I do it. First off, I do not glue any pages together, whether it's a composition book, whether it's any kind of thin paper book or magazines. I don't glue any pages together to make them thicker. Nothing wrong with that. I'm just saying, I don't do it. The other thing is I don't gesso my pages. What you'll see in these is how I address covering backgrounds. Some I just use white paint. Some I will use the act, just go straight in with the color. So I do not use gesso. Not that there's, again, there's nothing wrong with using gesso. I just don't take the time to do that. For me, these kind of things are play, experiment, testing, those kind of things. They're not, I'm not trying to do big pieces, finished works of art, and it's not like a canvas, which I've done some of those too. It's been a while since I've shown those too. So that being said, when you work in a magazine journal like this, and you glue, like this one has two glued together, if you don't work some here, then some in the back, some in the front, some in the back, some here and there. And if you don't go back and forth between the front and the back of a thin journal, this is what will happen. Your spine will warp. Okay? If you don't want this to happen, work front to back, front to back, front to back. Okay? This doesn't overly bother me, but I know that freaks some people out, especially in our group with the OCD. So if that bothers you, work front to back, front to back, front to back, and then you'll have less of that. Okay? Here's one where I've worked front to back, front to back, and it's still thick and warped and thick and fluffy, but it's not as warped as that, right? Okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of do a little flip. I've done a flip through these before, and it is uploaded to YouTube probably close, maybe to a year ago. I'm not sure how long ago I did looked at them. It's months ago, anyway. And I'll show you how I use them and what I do with them. Just like in color booking, color books are excellent for shading, practicing your shading and your blending, whether you use a wash of acrylic paint as a base and then going with color pencils, whether you use markers. And like last week, I showed you four different things to use as a wash before you use your color pencil on it, on those flowers. Well, in the same way that that's good to help you shade, these are good for helping you match colors. Not necessarily blend, but match. Crocker 2, you got freaked out. You cut the spine. Oh, okay. Yeah, this freaked you out? Yeah. Yeah, so you got to work front to back. Okay. Julie said her magazine journals warped, but then so is she. Oh my goodness. So this is the calendar page that I'm using for a focus this week. Don't forget to play. All right. So anyway, let me just kind of take you through some of the pages. Now I will probably skip some if I have some few personal notes or something on them. Most of them I've got pinned together. So anyway, there's not a whole lot of personal stuff in these, but I want to show you how using an old magazine is an excellent way to help you match colors, not blend, although you're going to see a lot of other techniques, splattering, scraping, dragging, and all that. But the initial bits, let me find one to give you a good example. Okay, here's a good example. And I was practicing writing messy here. I wrote this with just a scratchy pen, you know, just to play here. But what I want to show you here is this was already here. These images were already here. Now, again, my camera's probably going to skew the color somewhat. Sometimes it'll flash it out. Sometimes it'll get really dark. But hopefully you'll be able to get the idea. Cinnamon Cooney posted the portrait. Oh, she did. I know she used, one of the girls said that Cinnamon Cooney, the art Sherpa, posted the portrait I drew of her. I know she used it. She changed her Facebook avatar to that picture. So did Shannon when I did hers. But anyway, good. Thanks, guys. So what the magazine journals help you do is look at the colors in the images and match them. Okay, now again, this is not a hard, fast rule. You don't have to do this. You don't have to, you know, it's just some ideas, some creativity, some inspiration. Don't email me. Okay, so when I say don't email me, I don't mean nice emails. You can email me anytime, anybody can. But I'm talking about, you know, oh, well, that's the only way to use a magazine journal. No, it's not. Okay. So, anyway, so I took the black and the yellow and the golden, you know, the yellow ochre and all that, and I played with the colors. I tried to match them as best I could. Now, granted, there are tons of colors in Americana and other craft paints that you could probably match up pretty close just using, see, this one's kind of dried out. See, this is what I'm talking about. This is why I want to use these up. These were all on my paint cart. These ones laying down right here. So it's a good way to practice matching colors with other images, which you would think, well, what's that stupid? Well, no, it's not, because you're practicing your color matching, okay? And then a lot of times you're not going to have the exact color. It helps you to mix your own colors and see how close you can get. Oh, thanks, Embers Rose. Thank you. She said they're like dreams. Well, you know, so here's the thing. This is a good way for you to practice multiple things. Some of this, there's a little bit of collage in here. Not a lot, but you can also collage. But what I would recommend starting with is getting rid of all the text on the page. Don't feel like you have to do the whole, don't do like me, do the whole magazine in one sitting. I've done that here on, well, not here on YouTube, but on Ustream. I spent one, I think we did, I don't remember how long it took, a couple hours maybe, and we base coated every page in a magazine. Oh, I was tired at the end of that one. So don't feel like you have to rush. Take one or two pages at a time, you know what I mean? Yeah. So it just helps you to match colors, mix colors, and all that sort of thing. And then you can go in here and turn it into an art journal. Then you could slap some more collage on it and blend it. You can do lots of other things with it. But this is just like a base, okay? So some of them have further additions to the you know, the layout. But a lot of them you're going to see don't. And you're going to see me show you how to do that. Okay, so let's start at the beginning. Again, you're going to have multiple different kinds of things in here. On this page, I just covered the whole thing with some blue, some Stencil, wiping with the baby wipe, which I will need my baby wipes. That's my favorite blending tool. And some places I will cover up all the tack. Some places I'll leave it peeking through. It's totally up to what you like to do. Okay? So, yeah. Thanks, Rain. If you have any questions, put them in caps so I know you're talking to me, because it does scroll by pretty quick. I have about a 5 to 10 second window before the comments are gone with so many people talking. So if you want to get my attention, put them in caps. Otherwise, Carrie or Eileen will re-yell at me. I mean, get my attention politely. Okay, so... I like to have fun, guys. What can I say? All right. So, again, this one has just got some Stencil, some sprays. You can test play with your sprays. And it doesn't necessarily have to mean every single page has to be, like, color coordinated to everything. This is just part of it, okay? And so I left some of the contents little imagery there, but I covered up all the text. In this case, it's white. So if you see a completed white page on the back, it's not gesso. It's just plain old white acrylic paint. But you don't have to use white. You can use whatever color. Some of the pages, I just go right in with a color. Some I want to get rid of the text, and it might take coating it with white or gesso, if that's your preferred method. You know, so yeah. All right, so here, this Lively Art of Lettering, that is a segment in the magazine. I left it. I liked it, okay? But I kind of tried to match some of the background images to that color. This one, I think, has more stencil work and stuff than this one. This one is going to have more, you'll see where, let's see, okay, like this. This one has more things like this. All right, so there may be a little tiny bit. This is the only bit of the magazine I saved. These little bits of a dresser thing, and I think I even glued that in. So, but what I did is I based all my colors on those little bits of images. So that's where I'm going with this. The idea is to take whatever little bit of picture that you like. Now, again, you can get rid of all the rest of whatever you don't want and just keep that one little bit of that you like, and then try to coordinate many colors, even a couple colors to start with. Try to coordinate them with your image and get you a whole color vibe coordinated thing going on. Okay, so this one's going to have more of that kind of thing than this one, which I think I did more stenciling and spraying in this one. So we'll just go through them and we'll see what, you know, we'll see where we're going. Okay, a positive negative study. That was the article. Okay, so I left the article title there. And in this case, left this one little thing, that. This is all that it's left, other than the words and this. All the rest is stencil, color, scrapey, blendy with your baby wipe, whatever. Now, sometimes it may take, if it's heavily text and you want to get rid of the text, you will probably, I don't use gesso, I just go straight for the paint, but, you know, you might want to do that. And again, I like Americana paints and craft paints, even the other brands. I haven't had a trouble with sticking, but you do want to make sure they're dry, okay? I had my heat gun, and I was just like heat gunning as fast as I was painting when I did this on the show. Hey, Jeannie, how you doing? Anybody else popping in? I think I will put a couple of my little Dilutions paints under here to kind of prop that up until we get toward the back, because it's making it, like, lean. Okay, Crocker 2, go food shopping. That's important. I'm recording. Okay. All right. So I'm just going to do a little flip. Again, this was already on the page. This was on the page. But I added, in this case, I added some stamping. And this is napkin. And the reason I can tell is because I can feel the napkin. When you use a napkin in your journals, you can tell. You can feel the napkin, right? So I use little bits of napkin. So again, you can play with matching the colors in the picture. And then add other elements that you want, right? All right, so just saying, you can do multiple things. It's mixed media, people. What did I use to make the polka dots? What, that was a stencil. That was a stencil. Stencil. Stencil and sprays. And I've got all kinds of sprays. You can make your own. You can mix, make washes. You can dab it on. There's lots of, I just like the quickness of the sprays. Hey, Angie, anybody else popping in? Thanks everybody for being here. So I'm just going to kind of flip through. Again, this was on the page. This was on the page. I got rid of everything else. But you don't have to necessarily leave it like this, and this isn't necessarily done. I might want to go in here with clouds, more moons, splatter some stars. So you're going to see all these pages are in various stages of completion. Okay? All right, so here's one where I've just whited out the text and whited out what I didn't want. And I think some of these I did to show what to leave. I mean, some of the, I know I do demos on the show, and sometimes I don't get back to them, right? Because we got to try to get as much in as we can. But you could leave some of the words, the titles, and then paint out. Look, I painted out three major areas and left these. So whether I want to keep these or where I want to go with it, Oh, question. Major announcement. Sam's Club has a, okay. Angie Bill said a major announcement. Sam's Club has a set of 36 Prismacolor pencils on sale. Awesome. How much are they? Oh, for $26. So there we go. Attention, Kmart shoppers. Remember that? But this is Sam's Club. So Sam's Club has 36 Prismas for $26. Thank you, Angie. You enabler, you. We're all good about that. Okay. Again, a little bit of left there, this. And it's all in different stages, but this is how you can see how it starts. You can scrape paint on, blend paint out. I won't do, I'll find one that has nothing done on it yet. So, but I want to, let me do a flip and then we'll, then we, because it's going to take me a good 30 minutes to flip. So if you don't want to watch a magazine journal flip, fast forward, people. Okay, so see, this was on there. It said treasures. I left that very faintly showing. I stenciled around, mixed the colors that I wanted to match or coordinate. It doesn't even have to match. It could coordinate, right? So there you can see the little bits that I left. And then you have, this is free, your free to art journal in it. Now, you're going to have to probably use something if you're going to be writing on acrylic paint. You're probably going to need Bic, the Bic crystals or something that, a Sharpie will just be gone like that, a Sharpie marker, or that'll they don't, acrylic paint and Sharpies don't play well together. So if you're going to do journaling in here, you're going to want to find what the pens, whether it's a gel pen or whatever to write with a Bic, but you want to make sure that's dry too, because that'll smear, Bics and those kind of things. Okay, here's with one palette. I did this on the show one day. We did this for some kind of a challenge, I think, using stamps and something else. I forgot what it was, but we used with one palette. So there's different projects might be mixed in here too. But just so you can see, here's one. I left the special features and just picked out one little bit. Rest is white paint. And then you can put whatever color that you want to coordinate with this in there. Okay, so here's an example of one done. Okay, so like you start with this. If you want to get rid of the text, you don't have to necessarily go over it with white. Sometimes you like that stuff peeking through. It just depends on what you want to do. So here we've done all kinds of scraping, blending, and color matching with, like, maybe I think I see three colors in there. So again, it's just whatever you want. This one's done. Or, well, I say done. I don't mean completely finished. Thanks, Angie Bell. So just to show you what you can do, that was a thing with a Paula Deen thing. It just kind of shows you what you can do with some paint. So here I just left the chessboard, backgammon and chess, and then used the colors in this and did this, right? And again, now you can go in here and do other things. You could draw on this pencil, and you know that goes great on top of acrylic. Might be able to do so that. Don't think this is not rocket science exactly. Hey, Orla, is just looking at the colors that you're leaving and playing with them. We'll do some here in a minute. That's why I pulled out all these old paints here. I want to try to use up. But I'm just going to kind of show you a flip first. So again, you know, then you can ink the edges. You can play with all kinds of things. All your mixed media is good for playing in this. Okay. So this one had imagination on the page. I left that, used those colors in the background. So again, to me, the most beneficial thing in doing this type of thing, just the base painting thing, is the color matching and the color mixing. That to me is the most beneficial out of this whole process. Okay. And again, these are two magazines glued together. But just so you can see, you can just play away. Make it messy. Make it playful. Then this is one of my hand-carved bee stamps there. That's a stencil. This is a stamp. The clock is a stamp. And then the little bee is one of my hand-carved bee stamps. Okay, now remember, these are from like 2011 and 2012. Okay, this one, we used, I think it was a foam stamp, could have been a stencil. But again, it's the colors. It's about the coloring and the coordinating. See that little bit of tealy color in there? That's such a pretty, like, blue color in there. But, you know, here, let me just do a little quick rabbit trail here. I should be using this one because I want to use this up. So I'm going to go with this one here. No, I think I'll go with this one. I've got a couple different ones here that I don't even know how good they are anymore. But, that one's still fine. I have a lot. If you weren't here a minute ago when I showed all the paints that are laying right here that have been on my paint cart for a while that I just want to use up. So, again, you can start with a few different things. You can start with just... Now, I've already got some stuff on here. I'm just going to add to this one because I really am inspired by the orange and the blue. Okay, but you can add in... You can add in some just by scraping, right? And then taking your baby wipe and, you know, moving it around, blending it out, leaving rough edges. Maybe you want to sort of highlight those leaves. You know, it's all totally your whatever's up to you, your style. Or if you don't like it, just, you know, let's just get rid of it, right? I do like this up here. I like the scrapey darkness of it. So I think I'm just going to do some more scraping in here. Now, when you do the scrapey like this, it's pretty thick. It's on there thick, right? Maybe you want to go over some of the orange. What I'm trying to get at is that this is pretty thick when I'm scraping it on like this. So you want to make sure if you're moving through quite a few pages, you want to make sure it's dry with your heat gun. Or what I'll do here is I'll get out some, you know, I keep excess pieces of wax paper laying around to do for that. Because sometimes a heat gun won't completely dry it and you're moving on. So I at least give it an initial dry. But I'm playing with the colors here. I'm not necessarily trying to make something. Although it could end up being something later. But maybe I just, you know, want to just play with color that day. So just having a book that you can play color play in without feeling pressured to, oh, I've got to do a full-on mixed media collage like I do in my art journal, because my art journals are more formal, right? So these magazine journals, you're not using up a new book. You're not messing up a $25, $30 journal. It's just a magazine. It's just a magazine. All right, let me find some wax paper. I know I got some wax, loose wax paper here somewhere. Ah, here we go. So once the paint dries on these wax paper bits, I pulled that out of a journal there, along with my paper. Once it's dry, you know, they're still good for, you know, sticking in between until they're 100% dry. Now, once it's dry, I don't really have a problem with my paint sticking. I don't use Mod Podge, though, just saying. Just a reminder. Okay. Now, you do want to be careful. Right here, I'll give you another tip. If you're going to scrape paint or do a full-on edge-to-edge paint, you probably want to put wax paper behind the page. Otherwise, when the paint goes seeps over the edge, you might glue those pages together. So you do kind of want to be careful if you are going off the edge of your pages to put wax paper between them so you're not gluing the pages together. Great, because you feel so free. Yes, exactly. You just got a bunch of magazine imagery to coordinate around. This one we did a hand drawing. I forgot why. Somebody wanted to draw a hand, so I just put my hand up there and we drew. So here you can see this page had pink, yellow, and magenta in it. So we played with some colors. And these little designs here, not the yellow circle, but the pink little bits, that was already on there. So we took that and used it to play with. That's like a little design element you can pick up, you know, off the page. Whatever it is. This one has to do with using postage stamps. So this one has got quite a few just white pages, and the other one I think is more completed. But I wanted to show them to you first before we... So again, I left the two images, played with all around it. This is washi tape here. So I put some washi tape strips around it because it had those colors in it. So use your washi tape. Use all your mixed media. Use it all. Okay, so let's get to some other pages. And again, mostly what I'm trying to do is just get rid of text. Bye, Galena! Hey, Dasha! Okay, so here we go. This was here and those were there. Then we added all the rest, stenciling, painting, and again, you know, whatever colors suit you. And then, I inked the edges on some of them. Took my inks and just inked the edges with it. So it's just all about playing with whatever. You can leave some text poking through just for like a nice, cool little background. This one had some birds on it, and then we just drew our own. I say we because if you guys are here, we're drawing together, you know. So these birds were on the page. These butterflies were on the page. So we just made our own little branch connecting it and drew our own bird on there. So you can add your own drawings and paintings and mixed media, whatever, in the page. So this had just a big white space. So we just put a bird on it. Yeah, Dasha, I'll have to go. I can't go while I'm streaming, but I'd like to see your site. Okay, so here again, scrapey, blendy, just picking a couple of colors that were in the little floral imagery and scraping paint, blending some, but you gotta let it dry or put some wax paper because if this is thick and you close it, it's stuck, you know. Okay. So I hope y'all Yeah, because if you're here and I'm talking with you guys and stuff, I feel like we are doing it. And hopefully you're doing something, at least writing down notes. At least write down some notes. No, Linda, I mean, Lindsay, you're not drawing telepathically with me. You should be writing down some notes. Okay, so that little bit of paint right there, see, it is wet. Okay. This one's got some washi tape. I don't know why we did segments. There was a reason for all of it. Okay, so here's where the two came together. And I have some things kind of taped off there, but so this is where I showed you the first one. This is now we're into the second journal. Okay, and again, I was practicing with just a dip pen, trying to make it real scratchy on purpose. Some of these are a little on the dark side, you know, but put quotes on them. You can put your quotes. Famous pears. I'm sure this was a wingnut moment for all of us. We had some pears. Famous pears. Yeah, I'm sure it was a wingnut moment. So yeah. So you can just kind of see again, playing with the dip pen and making it scratchy. Oh, good rain. So you can see how you can take. You know, this to me needs some nice fluffy white clouds coming right across. You know, maybe a collage element, some water. You know, you can play. But the base, this is the base. Because I do have people ask me, well, how do you start the base? Well, in a magazine journal, it's, you know, look how easy. Just scrape on some color. That's all this is scraping and painting in this segment. Okay, and some of the others we might have more stenciling. Okay, again, Alice themed something. Okay, that one's not done. These aren't done. Okay, here's one that it's got some on it. Again, playing with the dip pen, the scratchiness. And I know it's flashed out a little bit, guys. I'm trying to keep it not flashing out, but I want it bright enough so you can see the colors. It's kind of either too dark or too flashed out, but I do my best. So this one's got some splatter. See, this isn't taking it to the next level yet. Okay? It's just got the scrapey stuff on it. But then, you can, there's just so much you can do. Let me get a little black paint down here and a little bit of water. Fluffy brush. Get a little bit of paint. So, and of course, if some of you do and some of you don't like the dripping. You could drip down here, Okay. Now again, I'm not going to bother to dry this, but if you don't want these to splatter or smear, you'd want to dry it. I'm just going to stick a piece of wax paper in there. So again, here's a more muted page. You have a great mind for organizing because of your eyesight, you never relied on notes. That's true, Jean. You have a visual disability. That does make a difference as far as, probably have a great memory too, Jean. Okay, this one. I think we did this one on a stream. Took this image and just played with the whole thing. Same for this one. Now, I remember on this one, this did was not a windmill. We turned it into one. We drew our own windmill little fans, if you will. So, yeah. So you can see this one's got a little bit more done on it. So you can see different. This was underwater, so we were doing depth and deep and. This one had stars, dreams. You can take your cue from the picture. This one we did soul food. This one, no theme, just using the colors. This is a good one for color example. So if you just take and look at this and this, that was all that was on the page, and then we did all this. So you know, another good one, you know, where you can take and do a, where's my Posca white pen? Oh, I think it's over here. Here we go. You know, add more stars, or you know, a shooting star. Or, you know. So there's just lots of things you can do. You can make that moon a little brighter. You know, play with it. Put some, you know, glow halo around it. So play. This could have water reflections in it. Pull out a little white here. Take a little. And because it's a magazine too, and while it's wet, if you don't like it, look. You know, you can, there's a lot of, you can play with it for a while it's wet. You know? Know what I mean, Vern? Okay, my thing froze again. Let me scroll. I think I've got some questions. Hey, Colleen. Oh, thanks, Colleen. I had somebody ask me for your link to your Ustream the other day on YouTube, Colleen, because they wanted to see your calendars. Oh, well, good. Good. You're gluing today, Terry? Okay. Yeah, because, yeah, they want to see. I want to see all those calendars you talked about Colleen had. So I put your link to your Ustream in there, Colleen. All right, so I'm going to dry this just real quick. That's probably dry enough. If we come back and this one's stuck, you'll remember why, right? Okay. There we go. Let's get the keep one to flash out, but whatever. All right. So again, all just different. You know, whatever colors happen to be on that page is what I base the whatever off of. Okay. Here's one where we said imagination. I had beautiful imagination already in the little ad. So again, I was just playing. I don't even remember why we were doing this. Practicing with the scrapey, scratchy looking fonts. So we played with that for quite a few pages here. Okay. Wishes. There's a kind of a birthday cake looking thing. So did a lot of that. Sometimes you just keep one little thing. But they hold up pretty well. They don't fall apart. You know, a composition book can, or some books can, but the magazines are really, they'll hold up pretty well. Just so you can kind of see. All right, so this one, you can see again, it's got different, you can do tip-ins. I think we glued in some notebook paper to show that at one time. All right, so there's that one. Again, this is the one where I didn't go front to back. And so if you just go front straight to back, it's going to start to warp the spine. Should I go back and forth in a large calendar? I don't know what kind of calendar. It depends on what it's made out of. If it's a glued spine, you want to go front to back. If it's a spiral, of course, you know, that ain't gonna matter. Oh, sorry, guys. All right, so let's go on to the next one here. Again, this one has three in it. Sorry, guys, when I bump the calendar, it takes a minute to get it unshaky. This one has three magazines in it. And I was a little bit more careful. You know what it is? I think it's my fan. Hang on. There we go. I have my fan, and I think it's like lightly putting a little breeze on, over here on the camera. That was a great deal, not on the price and on the kinds of calendars you got. Sometimes those calendars are not, the dollar calendars. But, that's why I love going to my Books a Million in the first week of February because they have, and you did too. You found good ones that are $12, $15 calendars for a dollar. Every February at Books a Million, they go on sale for $3, no matter what price they are. I'm talking about like leather bound, little leather bound journals and things like that, $20 plan date planners, anything with a calendar in it goes on sale for $3. So this cover is that's a scrapbook paper. It is an actual shiny paper. I don't know if I can put my hand on it right off the bat. Let me see. Let me do a little flip for just a second. Okay, you're in luck. I was able to flip through my 5 feet or 6 feet. This is it. This is from the Steampunk Botanica. Again, it's two, three, I don't know how, I mean, at least this is from 2012. So it's at least 4 years ago, right? So, and it was probably right at 4 years ago because I probably loved it so much that I started a new magazine journal covering it with this. So I don't know if it's still available anywhere. Recollections is the Michaels brand. That's the Michaels brand. And Steampunk Botanica, 48 sheets. Of course, I don't know how many are left in here now, but we'll flip and do a little flip. Rabbit trail. But what I was going to say is these have the shine to them. Okay, they're the shiny. All right. And then it has some of the embossing. See the embossing there? So this, that, that cover is out of this stack. Okay, see, it's all embossed. Isn't that pretty? Hi, CB. Thanks for stopping by. Okay, got a little skull up there in the bird cage. Again, although black, you see it's embossed. This was, a lot of people got this for Halloween. Paper, even though there's not all necessarily Halloween, but like this one has spider webs. Look, so it's got little spider webs, but I think it came out at Halloween. Again, there's some. Kind of cool. Embossed butterflies and all the keys and everything, but it's all shiny. And I usually don't go for the shiny papers, but I bought it because of the imagery, right? So all this is cut aparts, some little, just all kinds of things you can. Let me tear it out so you can see it better. It's hard to hold the whole pad, the whole stack up. So you can see it's all like, it's almost got like glossy accents on some of it, like embossed, like raised embossed. I think Carrie said she's gonna stream. Did I miss that? Thanks, Juju. Yeah. Colleen said she can't stream because her daughter's visiting. Yeah, Carrie mentioned it. I don't know if she still is going to, because Jean can't stream, and I don't know when else what the rest of my week's going to look like because Cam and Boo are on spring break. I don't know if they're coming down here. I'm going to go up there, go get them. We're going to the lake. I don't know yet. So, this one's got some strips. And again, it's like embossed around the watch. I might nap first. Okay. Oh, well, if you're not feeling good, good grief, Carrie, then don't. For goodness sake. Little spider on a chain. Little key on a chain. Little watch on a chain. So this is kind of, it's a little different. This one's got some little skulls in it. So yeah, that was the Steampunk Botanica. Came out probably, like I said, 4 years ago. Because this is 2012. Alright, so that's what I used on here. Then I duct taped them together. Well, I glue the covers. I'll take two magazines, the back and the front of another. Eileen's Tacky, completely covering front and back, and glue those together. That's what holds them together. But I also duct taped the spine, and then in this case, I glued over on top of the duct tape some washi tape. But you're going to have to glue that. That washi tape's not going to stick well or last for long, if it sticks at all, on the duct tape. So you want to glue that on. Okay. So this one's got some little drawings, some doodles. We did some stamping. There's my little hand-done rabbit trail. I started doing a table of contents. I think I did have a plan for this at one time. These are my little rabbit trails. Maybe it was a rabbit trail book I was going to do. You know what I mean, Vern? Maybe it was a rabbit trail book. Not sure. But these pages are further along a little bit more. Like this is all hand done. Little bricks in the background. So you can use it to doodle in. But essentially, it is all the same process, right? It's all the same process of scraping the paints and matching the colors. I need to prop this up because I'm gotta, again, it's not going flat. There we go. Thanks, Rain. Yeah, they're fun. So you can just see, you can do topics, you can do topics and then quotes. A lot of scraping. Some of them I really wanted to look really like peely paint. Peely paint. This one kind of came up, one page came apart, I threw some duct tape in there. I mean some washi tape in there not too long ago. So any questions? Y'all got the idea, right? Got the idea of just scraping some of these paints? Okay, so here's one where I added a little bit of collage, a little bit of leftover scrapbook papers. So you can also use these for like a desk journal where you're using up, scraping up the leftover paints. So like, let's take a little bit. I don't know if this is, it's pretty much, I think that's the color I use. Let's get some orange. Orange and gray. Let me get a fresh palette because I don't want to mix it in with the black and the blue. Let me find another palette. Hang on. Not that I don't have any more of those babies. I mean, I got stacks of these. You know, and the thing is what's cool about these is after you use them for a while. Now, a lot of people, when you put paint on top of other colors, it bothers them and they can't distinguish. It's probably best if you're using white palettes. The black palettes don't bother me, neither does adding paint on top of paint. But that can be visually distracting when you're trying to, especially if you're trying to mix or match colors. Look exactly like Sabrina Ward Harrison's book, None of Us Can Bear to Journal It. I can't bear to journal in mine either. I don't know, somebody said Sabrina Ward Harrison. Yeah, I think I got all but maybe one of hers. Maybe I have all of them, her books. And you're right, we don't journal in those. But if you're doing your own, you can. But anyway, what I was going to say is they make the nice paint skins. Now, this one's not coming up in a nice big chunk. But I've never found anything that really attracted me to using these. Everybody goes, oh, save those paint skins. They're really cool. So I saved some, and I have a baggie full of them, but I don't have any inspiration to use them. I just got to say. It just doesn't inspire me to use them, even in collage. You know, as much collage as I do, you'd think that I'd love using these things. No, I don't. I don't love using them. Yeah, but I do keep a nice stack of them. All right, so let me just kind of set that over here for a minute because I wanted to put out some orange. Yes, I'm live. Hi, Island Girl. I'm live. I'm live every morning. Okay, now, so I somehow picked up a brand new one of these. I get my X-Acto knife and cut that open. I'm trying to use up all the old ones, and I picked up a brand new one. Yeah, we're playing in magazine journals. It's just a play, just a little bit of a... All right, let me put that up there because that's new. And then let me get some... That's kind of maybe too blue, but we'll go with it because I'm trying to use it up if it's in these leftover paints. Let's even see if that one's not even any good. See? So that one's all hard and old, so that goes in the trash. That's why you want to use your paints. All right, let me get a bit of gray. And this one's almost gone. I'm almost out of this color. Okay, so there's a couple things you can do with your paints other than scrape. All right, so, but let's do a little scraping first. So I'm going to scrape on some orange here. And again, I'm kind of trying to match, you know, it's not match, coordinate, but I am trying to show you the matching them now. I need some more coffee. Sounds like somebody's cooking something and nobody's here. I don't think something's wrong. I better go down and check my coffee pot. Doesn't smell like something burning. It smells like somebody's cooking cookies or something. Somebody must be cooking something outside. All right. So you can kind of see. Maybe it's, is it my fan? No? All right. So I'm just going to put down a little bit of that. Now I'm going to pick up a little of the gray, the blue-gray here. It's bothering me that I can smell cookies being made. All right. Okay, they can be your next giveaway. Send them to, the paint skins? Yeah, I don't know. It would have to be somebody that really would know what to really... you know, do with them. I don't know. I just never, you know, and I've seen people use them in different collage-y things. I just don't have an inspiration to use them, you know, use paint, the paint skins. All right, let me go get some fresh coffee and go down there and see what I'm smelling. Because it must be one of my neighbors cooking cookies or something. I don't know. But there's a couple colors, right? Just put a couple colors on. All right, I'll be right back. Oh, no. Hubster made brownies yesterday? Maybe there's some residual brownie scent. I mean, just plain old chocolate brownies, people. Melvin. No, Mel Vint, is it Mel Vint, Vintage Rose? What does Dee Dee get her stencils? What are they called? I use all kinds of stencils, Mel. Store-bought ones, cut on my Cameo ones. But speaking of, since somebody mentioned stencils, let's go ahead. I bought these last 2 weeks ago, I think. I got them on sale, the Faber-Castell. And I know I can cut any of this stuff out on my Cameo, right? But yeah, I think I got them for $2. So I couldn't pass them by. So this one's got some dots. Let's go with that. Where's that beehive looking one? This one that looks kind of like, there we go. This one. Let's go with this one. We're just doing some backgrounds. I've had people asking me recently about backgrounds, how I start the journals. Of course, if you see me do my art cards, that's how I usually start. But in this case, in this case, have you like that, Julie? These are magazine journals. They're just magazines where I'm painting out the different elements and leaving what I want. So now let's go with the dark orange, or almost could almost be deep burgundy. I'm gonna pull out a little deep burgundy here. And we'll get a sponge. I just use makeup wedges, okay? And we'll take this one and we'll just kind of do some random stenciling. Maybe I'll pick up a little of the orange and the burgundy. Guess see there's burgundy in there. I don't know if y'all can even see that. And I usually don't even like to do stencils like edge to edge. I like to leave them kind of like faded on the edges, like this. I'm just throwing out some ideas there, guys. Y'all, use what you can or what you want or whatever. You like the beehive stencils? Yeah. And again, it was only because I could get them for like $2 that I picked them up, because all this stuff I can cut out on my Cameo when I use my Cameo mat. When I use the mat, right, Carrie? Y'all missed that one, yeah. You just kind of see here, guys. I'm just throwing out some, using up some paint. This is what you do when you have left. Oh, I picked up the white on the edge there. This is what you do when you have leftover paint or collage bits, or you can use it as a desk journal or whatever, or just scrape it on. Be yourself. There you go, Eileen. Well, now if I let's see. Do I have a liner? You know what? Let me find a. Well, we will do something, Eileen. Hang on. Let me grab a. Let's see. Let's do a couple things. Let's do some of this, some ink, and a pen, and a brush. Let's see what we can do. We're going to put Be Yourself on this because Eileen suggested it. I'll squeeze out a little paint in my little slate thing here. Okay, now we can do it a couple ways. I can do the scratchy bits. We can do the scratchy kind like we did before. Let's see where yourself. Let's see if we can do. No, what? You know what? Let me do the brush first. Hang on. Let me get a thin brush, not a liner, but a. See, what's this one? That one's an angle brush. Here we go. We'll just take a little I have to stand up to do this, but I want to do it real free form. Like, because then I'm going to go in there and scratchy around it. Whoops, I need an L in there. That looks like a T. Be yourself. Okay, so what I want to do though is now take that and do the scratchy bit around it, you know? I don't have enough. Might need a wider tip. And just do the scratchy like we did on those other pages. I don't even know if that's showing up. Okay, maybe we can make this more into an L here. Need a little bit more scratchy on the B. Alright, so. Be yourself in April! Just in April, Eileen! Okay, there we go. Because that was already there. How do you make scratches look so awesome? Just don't be afraid. Just go in there and play. Okay, so there we go. Let me clean my brush off. Let me my nib off there a little bit. Although, as you can see, I'm not really one for cleaning my nibs that well. Okay, we will put this ink aside. We may use it again. We may not. All right, let me hit this with the heat gun because that for sure is, I can see the shine of it being wet. And an ink, if you don't want to smash ink, let me stop this. You don't want to take like a Kleenex and smash it, it'll spread. What you want to do with ink is wick it. Take a Kleenex and like suck the excess ink up like a little wick. Okay, that's how you, because if you just put something down there to sop up excess ink, it's just going to smear. Which like, I really worry about that with this, right? With all the scratchy. But I'm just showing you a little tip coming from a calligrapher. You don't want to... You want to wick it up like a, you know, like a wick. All right, let me finish drawing. It needs a little bit more wicking right there. Just a little bit. All right. Thanks, Terry. It's just thrown together with clay and paint and, you know. We actually should have made it B-E-E. Be yourself. You know what? I need. I've got it now. I've got to get my B stamp out. Let's see if I can find it. Hang on. You should see this room. You should see this room. All right. Let me get a couple of. Now I got to get out my. Let me smooth this. Have to set it on the floor because I have no room on the desk. It's in one of these two tubs. This tub or this tub. My B stamp. Let's see if it's in this one. I don't know who's tweeting me. Let me check my iPad. No. Somebody just liked my grandpa picture, I think. Whoops. All right. So let's see what we got in this one. See, I do have stamps. Lots of my own hand-carved stamps. Like my gargoyle here. But I know I have my, here's my, I love this. Oh, where do I go from there? What's sticky there? That's the back of this. That's weird. The back of this stamp, one of these, the little plastic thing came off. Maybe it's not hot. I don't know, but it's sticky. It's like, look, what the heck? The sticky bit, look. It's like, and it's extra sticky sticky. Oh my gosh, look at that. That's like the image. The image is peeling off. What the heck? But the reason I noticed it is because it got on my back of my Lisa Scott thing. Stamp, my moon pie. I'm going to have to stamp some of these out so you can see. It's got her name on the back there, and it's all sticky now with that stuff. What the heck? Wicked good. Very good. Wicked. Wicked good. Sammy jammies. Wait, that's got to go in the wingnut book. Trouble Terry. When wicking ink, whoops, it's I. Wick. Wicky good. Yep, you're a wingnut, Terry. You don't know about the wingnut book? Who doesn't know about the wingnut book? This is a book of when someone says something funny like that, I put it on a post-it note and it goes in the wingnut book. Look, we're running out of room. I told you when Denise looked at this when we were doing the cleaning here, she was looking at these and she goes, that doesn't make any sense. Like, let's just do one here. Okay, so Dana said an art fort. When your whole art space is covered, it's an art fort. And Denise always says, middle class problems. But anyway, it's just, you know, Jean is the procrastinator. Tam said that. We write this stuff down. You do know about it? Anyway, yeah. Wicked good. That went in there. All right, so. Have a trail. All right, let's go back to the stamp. So, I need some ink. Get my momentum. God, my hands are all sticky now from that. What the heck? How does that even happen? I don't even know how that happens. I'm tempted to throw this whole stamp in the garbage. Let me just take that whole, look. What the heck? It's a glue snot. Oh my gosh. All right. So yeah. Okay. All right. So now my hands are all sticky. Oh, good grief. Let me go wash my hands. Bugging me. All I did was want to get a B stamp. And you see, this rabbit trail was not my fault. I don't know what that is, Sammy. It was the covering. See, look, here's it on this one. It's the covering for the image, right? But it snotted up and stuck to my Lisa stamp. All right, so I'm going to stamp up my Lisa stamp here with my memento. I think this pad's still good. Just so y'all can see my moon pie. Lisa, our Lisa, this was the first stamp. Now I got to find something to stamp. I want to get my book back here. I won't put it on the bee one because be yourself with the bees. And the moon pie, well, I guess we could. It could be yourself. We're going to go for it. All right, so I'm just kind of inking up. This was the first stamp she ever carved. And she carved it in the pink stuff, that pink. And we're going to put it right down. Let's put it right here. Seriously love Mondays now. Aw, Sammy. All right, so let's see. And I'm not a stamper. Rach is our stamp. And speaking of Rach, the 7th, I think is it the 6th or the 7th, whenever it is at Prima, Prima does her Ustream. Rach is going to be on Prima this week. It's either the 5th. No, I think it's the 5th. I think it's Wednesday. Rach is going to do a be streaming. Okay, so yeah, there's my moon pie. It's It's a little, it came up, see, I went right over a bit of collage. Let me stamp it again on something else because I want y'all to see it. So awesome. Anyway, Rach is going to stream on Wednesday, I think. Wednesday on Prima. All right, let me just get a piece of paper. My hands are still sticky. Oh my God. All right, let me just get it. So I want y'all to see this. It's awesome. I said that to say because I am not a stamper. Y'all know that. Tomorrow is the 5th. Yeah, I guess it is. It's tomorrow, the 5th. Yeah. So Rach is going to stream, Rach0113, if y'all know her on YouTube, and who doesn't. Anyway, she's going to stream for Prima tomorrow. There, that turned out good. See, look. Isn't that awesome? See the moon? Because we had a whole running joke here for a long time with Moon Pie and RC Cola. But anyway, Moon Pie, people. Moon Pie. Okay. So Miss Lisa carved that for me. Look at that. Tomorrow. We love Rachel's tomorrow. Yeah, it's only a day away. Okay, Carrie's going to start singing for us. All right, so, yeah, that's my Moon Pie stamp. But I was looking for my bee. All right, let's go back in here. We're going back in. Okay, I have a Peas in a Pod stamp I carved. Oh, here he is. Here's my bee. And we'll go through some of these others. Now I'm curious to what else I haven't used in a while. All right, let me stamp my bee. Let me show you what he looks like on the paper first. Because this has got collage. It's not going to stamp perfectly. Okay. So here's my carved bee that I carved with. This is some of the thicker speedball stuff, I think. There's the little bee. What did Eileen say? Peek. I don't know if I want to know what Eileen's peeking at. I don't know if I want to know that. All right, so let me ink her back up. And let's do some. Uh-oh. I'm trying to do it on the... Oh, there's nothing under here. This journal's floating in midair. Let's put 3. We'll have to put 3 on there. Put one coming down this way. Thanks, Terry. See where the collage is? So just be aware of that. Doesn't bother me in this journal anyway. But, you know, you got to know. Same thing if you color book, glue something in from a color book page. That's what happens, okay? So let's see where else I want. Let's do one over here. I'm just going to put one flying off the edge. There. Okay, so there's my bee stamp, and I never clean them when there's just ink. I clean them when I use acrylic paint, but when I'm just using ink, I'm almost 99% of the time use black ink, and if I do go to use a color ink, I'll make sure and take this to a baby wipe. Here's my baby wipe. Where'd it go? I'll put it, I'll clean it off before I stamp with the color, but now I don't even see my baby wipe. Did I throw it away? Yeah. Oh, that's right. It had sticky stuff on it. Let me get a fresh one. So what I'll do is I can either stamp it off a bunch of times first, or I'll take a baby wipe to it before I use a color ink on it, which, again, I rarely use color inks. On my stamps, it's almost always black, but, you know, you do want to clean them before you go in with the color. Hey, Sarah O. All right, so there's your Be Yourself page. Well, partial page anyway. Let's see what other stamps I have in here. We'll put this aside for just a minute. We'll get back to it in a minute. Now I'm curious about what other stamps I have in here. Yeah. Carved leaf. No, that's not a leaf. That's, I don't know what that is. But I got all kinds of things. These are like my main ones that I use all the time when I stamp. I gotta say, these little these are good for. Hang on, let's bring our bee page back up. Let's get back into our black paint over here. Where's the black paint? Oh, wait. Where's the black paint? Got so many piles. Where's the black? Oh, here we go. Some black paint here. And just take your little in here. And go do some little circles. Some little connecting things. Here's another hint. Don't just try to hold your journal up in midair because it ain't working. See what I mean, Vern? I'm trying to do it in midair. Just to show you that you can use these little tubes. And it could be a toilet paper roll. It could be, you know, whatever. Now it needs something down here to carry it down. Right, just to bring it down the page here. Let's put a couple down there. Anyway, okay, so there's that. Let me clean that off a little because if I throw it in there with the paint, it will get all over my stamps. Okay. Let's see what else. What else can we experiment with? I'm looking for more glue stuff. No, that's these. That is these. Now, this one's not sticky. I mean, I can literally pull that off. But that other one's stuck, too. It's stuck to it. Here's a like a steampunk wheel. Got a tea bag. I have a coffee something, too. But I hand-carved all these. There's a little hand-carved hand, a heart, a little topiary. What else did I hand-carve in here? For these, that's just a little foam bit. I carved it. No, that's not a carved one. There's my peas in a pod. This one's cool. Let me go ahead and, I do like to stamp the peas in the pod in green, but I'm going to stamp it in black just so you can see it here. Let me just slide this. Let me just, I'm going to stamp it right here, guys. You won't be able to see me stamp it, but I gotta have this lid or something to stamp it on. It's my little pea pod. Again, don't email me, Rage. Didn't stamp completely. What else is in here? These Prima ones that I haven't, I think these are Prima. I got these, I think, a dollar. Haven't used them a couple of times. What else do I have in here? Some different little textures. These are always good to use in your journal pages. Here's another little, let me stamp this one out. Another, gargoyle. Stamp out my gargoyle here. Let's not knock over the ink. All right, I'm going to come right down here because I need some pressure. I need to put some pressure on it. I can't do it on the lid right there. All right, there we go. Little gargoyle. Else. I'm sure y'all are fascinated with this. Oh, no, again, what? Something wet? No, because it's not wet on the back of this. There's another one of my, you know, the end of a violin or a cello. Let's stamp that out. Ran into a bunch of questions while art journaling. My first place, who could I ask those questions to? You can ask them right here. With 80 people here, we can help you, Mel. It's like I want to say Mel V. Mel Vintage Rose. Mel Vintage Rose. I want to call her Mel V. Okay, let me stamp this out. Thanks, guys. We have to have pet names for everybody. But yeah, go ahead and feel ask the questions. Put them in caps. Put them in caps, and I'll re-ask them. And anybody here want to file in on an answer, feel free. Okay, so there's that one. One of the big pieces of, I think it's Speedball's, you know, carving stuff. What else? Of course, I'm making a big mess, like another baby wipe. Get myself another baby wipe. Yesterday. So anyway, feel free to ask questions. All right, let's see what else we got in here. A baggie that I'm sure was just like a to-go if we want to take stamps to-go, which I haven't gone anywhere, and I don't know how long to... One of those little foam things, you know, foam dot things. Oh, here's one of my little carved ink pots. I think you can see what that looks like. Scaly. I gave a whole bunch of these away. I think I kept one for myself. But it's just like a hodgepodge of stuff in here. Let's go to the next bin. Oh, stamps. These are just my loose stamps. I have most of my stamps that I, well, all my stamps that I demounted off the wood blocks, they're in protective, you know, in page protectors with a piece of cardstock between them so I can flip. But I have two bins of, like, this doesn't fit in a page protector. Know what I mean, Vern? So, and then I use these more often than any others. So that's why they're kind of loose in this bin. Same for the other bin. You should see my room. The whole floor is completely covered with stuff. That's going to take me an hour to clean up. Not that I mind. You guys are worth it. That handle is cool. Oh, yeah. You mean this? That's the, you know, the end of a violin. If that's what you're talking about. All right. So I'll leave these because we're going to go back to the art journal in a minute. But I, you know, we could use stamps. We could use these stamps in the magazine journal, right? All right. Let's go into this one. Let's see if we got any more hand-carved ones in this bin. Juice is not a stamp. I'm not a stamper. My stamping always doesn't turn out. I'm not a stamper. The scroll of a violin. Yeah, thank you, Music Gene. Yeah. Now, some of these, okay, I got to back up because my camera's low. Some of these I got to do in my planner. Not date planner. I gave one of these sets to Darcy last time she was here because I wasn't using them. But I got these Heidi Swap thing on clearance for like $2. So I kept this one because I think of the butterflies. Or I let Darcy pick which one she wanted, and she picked, I don't even remember what was on the other one when she visited. So these are like little tiny stamps. Same for these. They were on clearance or something. Some trees. Somebody sent me these. And then I've got just different bits of stamps here. We need to do a giveaway. Let's give away one of these. I got to keep this one because of the ink pens. But let's give away this one today. I don't know if somebody sent this to me. It's got something on it. Like, I don't know if somebody got it. Ah, Joy from Virginia. Let's send this off to somebody. Would somebody like bird cages and birds? We'll do a giveaway. Okay, but what I'm trying to do in here is look for my hand card. There's a pansy. I hope y'all can see the flower. Question. When you demount a stamp, how does it stick to the acrylic block then? Well, here's why I'm not a stamper, Terry. I usually don't even bother. I just ink it up and just use push it with my fingers. But if you want, you could put a little piece of double-sided tape. A little piece of, you know, just double-sided tape on your acrylic block. And then you can swap the stamps in and out. And this, you know, the sticky on a double-sided piece of tape will last for a while. Now, if you're OCD, not saying you are, and you can't stand a little piece of double-sided tape on your acrylic block, you know, you might want to find something else. Yeah, I'm not going to go with the carpet tape there. That's a Paula story there. But anyway, this is a pansy. I hand-carved a pansy. That's me and Grandma's flower. What else? Do I have any more hand-carved? Here's a hand-carved design. But look, I got all these blocks in here. Bits of blocks to, you know, use to carve more. And you can also use those, the Magic Rub white erasers for small ones. Like here. This is like a... No, I'm not sure if that's a piece of a Magic Rub or not. But I got all kinds of little bits. You can use all these little bits to make carved stuff in. Okay, so like here's my, here's one of my acrylic blocks. That, look, that's a piece of double-sided tape. Granted, it's not sticky anymore, but, you know, that's what you can do. Just put a piece of sticky tape on there. Now, these are also all came like this, right? They're already foam mounted. So, you know, just none of it bothers me. I gotta say, guys, I'll work with whatever. This one's foam mounted. Okay, here's another one of my bee stamps I've carved. Let's go with that one. This is really a rabbit trail day. That stuff's like clay. This is not like clay. It's really, I mean, unless you mean like soft, it's real easy to carve into. But so is a magic rub eraser. Like I said, I don't know if I got one in here. The magic rub erasers, they're real easy. Real easy to carve. All right, let's bring our journal back up here and let's go with the other bee. Put a few more bees on here. We're just playing. We're just playing here. Let's do one right here. So, yeah. This is a rabbit trail video. It is. Speaking of, I've actually got a rabbit trail. I've got a carved rabbit somewhere. He's around here somewhere. So these are some, and then tinier ones, you know, that I keep, like, there. Okay, so we will go, we'll pull this one out for a giveaway. Oh, here's a little coffee cup. What else? No, Sister Woman carved me that. Yeah, that's Jonna. Jonna carved me that one. She carved me the little coffee mug. Let's stamp that out so you can see that, too. Oh, let's do it on this white paper here. Yeah. If someone gives me a stamp or cards or anything like that, I try to put their name on it. So, a little coffee mug. Just like, for instance, look, my post-it notes on the back. From Janice. So I could try to shout out when someone has given me something. Okay, so let's put that there. And let's see what else we got. I have a little tray full too. Plus I have all my alphabets that I've carved. I've carved multiple full-on alphabets. All right, let's see. Oh, let's do a giveaway for all y'all that are stuck around for a couple hours here. And don't forget too, you can cut these out. You can cut these out and use them. Color them, ink them, especially if you've done a momentum or a stays-on ink, you know. Some people like a little white edge on their stamps, too, whichever way you like to, you know, cut them out with a little bit of a white edge, or you can just cut right up to the edge. I like the look of both. I'm just going to cut this one right up to the edge. So you can use... You can use your stamps. Not that y'all didn't know this. You're probably thinking, everybody knows that, Dee Dee. Everybody knows that. Well, I'm just talking out loud. So. Hi, Deb. Now I'm going to do a giveaway right now if you want to stick around for one more minute, Missy. One more minute. I'm going to do the giveaway from this. Yeah, Joy from Virginia sent this. So, we're going to do a giveaway. I don't think I've used them. I don't think they've ever been used. So, we're going to give this away. We're going to do it right now. Then we can go back to the art journal. Because we haven't finished flipping through the magazine journal. We haven't finished flipping through the magazine journal. All right. Let me get a piece of post-it note. Let me get my iPad with random.org. Where's my Sharpie? Where's my Sharpie? You should see this room. I mean, it's really, it's sad, people. It's sad. One stream of 2 to 3 hours, and the room, you just don't know. Because everything I do here, I just throw on the floor behind me until we're done. And I'm one of those people, when we're done streaming, I have to pick it all up and put it away. That's just me. You like this, Dan? Stream is looking as you want. You have a lot of packing. Okay. Okay, well, you already got a move date, Sarah? Hopefully we're still, let's see, let me put my journal back in. Look, we haven't even gone through that much. All right, we'll put this up here. I just want something to kind of focus the camera. All right, so we're going to do random.org. Don't do anything yet. Wait for it. Okay, between 1 and 100. Don't do anything yet. When I type in the word go, where's Vicky? I need Vicky here. Okay, when I type in the word go, when you see me type in the word go, put in a number between 1 and 100. You'll have plenty of time. I know there's a lag. You'll have plenty of time to put in a number. If there's a lag and you see everybody putting in a number, you know it's time to put in a number. So let me just bring up random.org, and I'll show that when we get to that point, because it will flash out the camera too. I should have random.org on speed dial, but I'll have it right here. We haven't done anything yet. Okay, let's get the camera. Come back to mama. Come on back. Okay, one number only. No. Okay, let's just stop. None of that's counting. We'll just give it a minute. We'll get the lag. None of that counts. Did anybody see me put in go? It's like herding cats. Oh my gosh, none of those numbers are going to count. Now we're going to wait. Now we got to wait a full another minute. I didn't put in go. None of those count. We're starting all over. Back it up, people. Beep, 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 beep. All right, Carrie. Carrie, let me know when I can type in go, Carrie, let me know. Oh my goodness. All right, I know there's a lag, so I'm going to wait a second. Wait for me to type in go, people. Lemmings. No, it's like herding cats. Now you can go. There we go. Carrie, we couldn't do this without you. I'm just saying. This would not get done without you, Carrie. I'll give everybody plenty of time. You know what I'll do while we're waiting? I'll cut something else out here. While we're giving everybody time. Everybody has time to put in a number. Oh my goodness. I just laugh about it. Yeah. I just laugh at your. You gotta laugh. But I do like doing giveaways. So we put up with the aggravation of the, you know, lag and stuff like that. But yeah, so see, you got these things, kind of things too, you can use, right? Trigger fingers, yeah. I'm waiting until I see no more numbers for a minute, and then I will, I'll type in stop. Island Girl, just put in a number and you'll be surprised if you win. Put in a number, Island Girl, between 1 and 100. Put you in a number. Okay, I'm not seeing any more. Island Girl, put in a number. All right, here we go. I'm going to type in stop. All right, so here we go. Let's generate a number. Ready? 2. Now, if everybody went over 2, we'll generate another number. Did anybody put in 1 or 2? If nobody put in 1 or 2, we will generate another number. It's okay, people. It's okay. Did everybody go over 2? Anybody? Has to be not over. All right, so nobody got it. Okay, so we're going to do another number. Here we go. Ready? 1. All right, obviously that's not going to count because nobody had it. Generate again. 31. 31. Closest to 31 without going over. Okay, so 31. That doesn't count, Angie, unless you had it earlier. You can't put in a number now. Did it? All right, so who? I'm sure somebody had under 31. Okay. Closest to 31 without going over. Oh, good, Island Girl. Oh, thank you. Carrie, help me here. Hurry, Carrie, help. Help me. Help me. Juju has 28, all right? Anybody have 29 or 30? Juju. Okay, Juju, I do have your address, don't I? Let me make sure. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Looking in my Rolodex. Looking. You're just Judy, right, Juju? Juju, are you just Judy? Okay, let me make sure. Juju, are you just Judy? I think you are. I want to make sure I have the right Judy, because I have Judy Patootie. I have lots of Judys. I have Wee Hootie Judy. Oh, my goodness. That was fun to say. Okay, yes. Are you just Judy, Juju? I'm waiting on the chat to catch up to me. So, Juju, are you just Judy? Bye, Deb. Let me make sure I have the right Judy, because I have that. I have your address if you are just Judy, Juju. Yes, okay, so it's just Judy. I thought so, but I wanted to make sure. Didn't want to send your prize out to the wrong person. Okay. All right, so next, let's get back to the art journal. That took a lot of time. It takes a lot of time to do a giveaway with you guys. Herding cats. That's all I got to say. All right. All right. So I do have your address. All right. So let's go ahead and keep flipping. Let's keep flipping. If y'all are just joining us, this is a magazine journal. And what I was trying to do, trying to inspire, was for you to use, and it could be any kind of magazine. It can be a decorating magazine, a home journal, a garden magazine. If you're into garden, a garden magazine would be awesome to do this. I just happen to use a couple of old Somerset Studio publications, Blogger, Apprentice, or I don't even remember now. Did these in 2011 and 2012. Yes, I did start a new recording for this segment. Thanks for asking, though, Carrie. Thanks for asking. Yeah, we're already in an hour and 45 minutes into this. When you use more than one magazine, do you go back and forth? Yes. Yes, I go back and forth between all my magazines. I mean, all my journals, Rain. Yeah, I've got, I think, four of these made. These two that I'm showing you now are the most completed. They're the ones that have the most stuff in them. That's why I picked these two to show you guys. Yeah. I'm a back and forther. I am. I'm a back and forther. So you can see. So this little bit, this bit, and a little bit of a bow right there. Okay, the rest is paint. Again, it's really scrapey, and you don't have to do it this messy. You can do it neater. You can do it, you can put the paint on and blend it out better. This is just how I start them. This is just how I start them, guys. These were the plastic, I think, behind the stencils. So I use those. Turn it into a gratitude journal. Going full screen. Okay, Jean. Bye, Jean. Go full screen, Jean. Jean's going full screen. Miss Jean. Green Jean going full screen. So I couldn't help but add that accent to that, Jean. Do I go back and forth in each journal? It depends on how much time I have that day. Like, you know, I probably just pick one, though, for the day. Don't make me work in 20 journals in a day, Rain. Don't make me. I'm sorry, guys. I'm getting tickled. Could do a little prayer journal. Look, there's a little girl with a praying like a little angel. And that was in the journal. That was in the magazine. So I just stamped prayer. You can do the scratchy kind of thing we did. This was there. This was there. These are some tags or something that somebody made, and so they're just fun to paint around. Again, I must have really liked that gray bits of scrapbook because I put it on quite a few pages. Oh, so anyway, just so y'all can kind of see some ideas. Okay, so this was already, this, let's see, yeah, that was there too, or just, yeah. The Beautifying Everyday Life, that was part of the page. I did a little, I think I was testing out the sparkly gel pen because I went around that with the, I don't know if you can see it, but it's got the glitter pen, the glitter gel, the star gel. And then this is just some little, you know, this was already there, that checkerboard there. So I probably just went in here and just drew a little checkerboard just to play with. So you can doodle on them. You do whatever. You're the boss of your art journal. But these are the kind of things, if you're not inspired that day, that you don't know what you want to do, if you pull out one of these kind of magazines, trust me, you'll get inspired. Hey, Cagefish. So you painted over the rest of the magazine page except where I wanted to show. Exactly. Exactly, Steffi. Exactly. These are magazines. That's why they're called magazine journals. Sorry, guys. I'm in a good mood on Monday. I don't know. I just am. But then I add other things, too. Like, that's a piece of scrapbook paper, right? But again, the reason that I wanted to bring these out and show you, not just for the, you know, the fun pages that we do, but because it helps you to how to coordinate and how to mix. How to mix your colors and choose colors. how to see colors. Because you're trying to pick colors out from the imagery that you're leaving. And see, some of it's more finished. Like this is more peely paint look. You know, this is a piece of collage right here. This was already on the page. You were confused. Well, that's because you weren't here when we gave the full explanation, Steffi. I think Rain wanted to know, if you glue two magazines together, the whole thing. Remember I said at the beginning, you want to go front to back, so that your spine doesn't warp. This one's warped a little. That's three magazines, but it's not warped near as much as this one. I already talked about that. Yeah, maybe you just missed it. If you don't go front to back, if you just go straight through the front to the back, see there's where the new magazine starts, see what happens to the spine? It'll warp it. So you want to go front to back. Oh, I'm just teasing you, Steffi. Hey, fishy, fishy. Yeah, no, I totally know people can't be here for the whole thing. People come and go all day long. I totally get that. All right, so this one I think we did this one on a show. And again, these are just all in process. It's a way for you to use your paints and play and try to coordinate and mix colors. Okay? But you can do like when I do the art cards, I'll turn them into much more. You can add more collage. You can add your paint. You can turn it into a full-on page if you want. But for me, these journals aren't for that. If I'm going to do a full-on, you know, mixed media collage art journal page, it's going to be in my Dilusions journals, right? This is just more for play, for testing, for getting inspired. If I want to do a doodle, it's kind of like a little sketchbook. You know, you can do whatever you want in it. Yeah, Jean and Ella canceled today. Carrie's going to fill in later. Yeah. So it's just like getting rid of everything. But look, there's nothing else done on this. Some pages are further along. Some, look, I just painted out the whole thing there. Okay, now this stuck, and I can probably tell you why. I splattered this for a demo, and I didn't let it dry. But, you know, just showing you here. Art is not for sissies. So, this is just a bunch of jewelry. But you can go in here with, let's do a little bit of painty here. I've got this blue paint that I wanted to use. Remember I told you I had a lot of old mixed match paints that I hadn't used in a long time. Let's put out some of that. And maybe a little bit of black. Let's mix the two. A little black and a little dark blue. Do you glue to? No, I do not glue any pages together on any magazine. I mean, in any journals. Well, now I glued the back to front. Okay, the two magazines, like the new magazines, I glue them together. That's to hold them in. But I don't glue any pages together. By the time you put paint and everything else on, they're not that as thin as you think. Right?
Okay.
Now, I'm not fussing at anybody. Just saying. Don't email me. I feel like glue. Well, you know, some people don't like to work on real thin pages. For me, gluing two pages together just makes it all the more wrinkled. Never mind the time it takes. It makes the pages even more wrinkly to me. So I don't even bother. The pages seem... well, let me find a page, right? Look, it's just that this is what without anything on it. Okay, this is what, I don't know if this, you can tell. It's the Somerset Studio Public, or the Stampington. They're pretty much all the same. So I hope you can kind of get a feel for that. They're slick pages. They're not that thick. But look, by the time you add paint, They're thicker. They're completely covered with paint.
Yeah, I know, Steffi. I know, Terry trouble. We just like giving her trouble. We like teasing. We like to tease. It's all in good fun. We're not being, nobody's being mean, believe me. Nobody gets to be mean around here with Eileen, Carrie, Janet, Vicky. You'll be gone in a heartbeat if you're mean. And that's not an invitation to be mean. Right, so let me go back to, where's my little stack of those stencils here? All right, so we use that. Let's just find something kind of, I don't know, I kind of like that design. Let's just go with it just because it's, and I'm just using these cardboard stencils that I got for like a couple of dollars on sale at Michael's or Hobby Lobby. I don't even remember. But yeah, so we're just playing with those because they're handy. So I'm going to pick up black and blue. I'm just going to kind of, and these stencils, they're cardboard, so it's not as, they're not as good as a plastic stencil for true stenciling. You know, this is just your art journal play, right? Pick up a little bit more blue. We're just giving you some inspiration today. What are everyone's thoughts about an art journal and a mixed media spiral book? Well, I have almost, I'd say the bulk, other than my dilutions journals, I use the Canson mixed media. They're all spiral bound, but I despiral them because I don't like working around a spiral. So what I do is, let me show you a few here. And of course, they're all covered now, but they're those blue Canson XL mixed media. I take the spirals out and I put these book rings. They don't get crunchy, they don't stick together, they lay flat. So I take the spirals out of them. So I despiral. We won't cry if you finally glue those stencils in a page. Yeah, you know what? That's not a bad idea, actually. Maybe I'll glue this one in. Yes, we've done that before. All right, let's see here. Let me use, I've got to cover the whole thing with glue first, whether I do it right here or whether I, but I just wanted to see, show you, you can use bits of the stencil. You don't have to use the full-on square, right? You don't have to use everything in this square. It's just kind of cool if you just kind of go around, especially if you want to blend in your magazine images. That's a good way to do it. I'm just playing here, guys. I have no plan right now. This is just total, total play. All right, let me get a piece of wax paper. We're going to put that on here, and I'm just going to cover up the whole stencil with black and blue, and we're going to glue this baby in. Crusty stencils. It's not crusty enough yet. And these are not the best stencils for like true on neat stenciling. They're cardboard like, they're like cards, heavy cardstock. It's kind of like when I use my Cameo silhouette stencils. They're good for a, I use, 90-pound cardstock, whatever, 60, 90, whatever works. But they're good for a few applications. And of course, if you let them get, if you put the paint on them and let them dry, especially if you do it back and front, there and let that dry, it even makes them sturdier. Okay, but look, you know what I think I'm going to do though? I'm going to do take it one step further. I'm going to cut off the border here. Now, this is where you need the Scotch Quick Dry that Eileen uses, which I don't have, but it's got that tiny little applicator and little, it's easy to glue things down. But I don't do a lot of gluing with my cutouts. I mean, I do a little. I mean, I love my, don't get me wrong, I love my Cameo. I wish I had time to use it more. Now, we couldn't talk for a while. Yeah. that was a nice plastic stencil in that case, that one I glued down that other art journal. So I'm just going to turn this over. Let me put it over here where I can see where I'm gluing. And I'm just going to kind of go around here on this wax paper. I'm just going along the little edges. You can't see it. I'll show you in a second. The other thing that bothers me when I glue things in journal is if they're not glued down all the way to the edge. So if you put on glue like this, this is a stencil, it's a little bit different case, but I don't like the lumpy, bumpy glue, and I like to get all the way to the edges. I like my edges all glued down, so I'm usually, not necessarily, I don't glue stencils down every day, but I do like all my elements to be glued down well. Okay, so this is just some Eileen's tacky. Again, if you got the quick Scotch quick dry like Eileen uses on her cards. All right. Yeah. All right, now let me clean my glue off. I'll just kind of tack it down with a baby wipe so I'm not sticking my finger back in the glue. There we go. But I can cut these out, guys, with my Cameo. Okay. Get rid of the piece of paper with the glue on it. And I will put a piece of wax paper over it so it doesn't glue these pages shut. You wish you had detail in sketching. Produce them in your sketchbook for class. Well, what are you trying to draw? Maybe we can help you. We got all kinds of inspiration around here. Okay, so again, let me kind of try to work through some of the pages. Here's some that have nothing. This one's just like that. This one hasn't been done anything to. So just so you can kind of see. Well, I got to tell you, on the drawing sketching thing, you got to practice. There's just no two ways around it. You have to draw a lot. And, you know, since I've retired from visual merchandising, I'm in here all day. I do this full time. I don't just pick up a pencil. Not saying you do. But I don't just pick up a pencil for 30 minutes once a week. You know what I mean, Bird? I draw all day. Now, all day. And speaking of drawing, I don't want some paint on Grandpa. Let me move some of this out of the way. Here's my latest drawing. If y'all missed it earlier, I don't want to touch the page because I got paint on my hand. But here's my latest drawing. And again, it's a little flashed out, guys, because I've got the light setting really bright for the magazine journal. But there's my tribute to Grandpa. But I want to move him off the table because paint's flying. All right, so let me kind of flip through here to some of the ones that are more finished, because what I wanted to show you was you can use your stamps, you can sketch, you can draw. If you don't know what to draw, there's all kinds of little books like this for you to get ideas from. That pink matches my sleeves. It's so funny, the things y'all pick up on. Y'all crack me up, really do. So, yeah, but this is all just these books for me, and what I hope that you will get out of it is to help you coordinate, mix, and match your paints to different imagery. It's just a good practice. You would be surprised. But then you can go in there and add, I think it's my other one of these that I've actually gone in and inked every single page. Just kind of doing a quick flip here so you can kind of see. But you can go in here and play The magazines that come with the free clip art pages. Yes, I do. And I'll tell you why, because those are the two only two books, the Art Journal and the Somerset Studio, are the only ones I don't cut up. These are made by Stampington, like, but they're not the Somerset Studio, which I've collected since 1996. Exactly. Every, you know, I mean, I have, there's some awesome, awesome artists I look up to. And I have awesome books that I think, look, let me show you one of my favorites. I can put my hand right on it. Let's see. Well, I've shown you James Christensen. But let me show you another one if I can find it real quick. I'm looking for it. Don't know. I haven't looked at it for a while, so it might be. Come on, guys. I'm looking. Well, I can't find it right now. Can't find it right now, and I might be downstairs. But it's the botanical, the artists that draw botanicals, like realistic botanicals, and then like James Christensen, Nick Bantock. There's a whole bunch of artists that I love, and they inspire me. And you know, I hope that what we do here inspires you for, you know, different reasons. But to draw well, it does take a lot of practice. In there. Yeah, but you do want to keep your old drawings. I got a closet full in there. I've got 3 or 4 feet of old drawings in the closet since I was in high school, well, before high school. I don't have a whole lot before high school. I have a few old drawings. I didn't keep them back then. Like, I make Cam keep his. But I got, you know, 3 or 4 feet of drawings in the closet. Old ones. James Christensen belongs to you, Eileen. Well, painting, if the better you draw, the better your paintings will be. It's just, they go hand in hand. Okay, well, I'll get off out of the teacher mode there for a minute. But what I wanted to show you is like something like, I just, because I saw these flowers here, these kind of, you remember when I did the clip art show a couple weeks ago, how to use your clip art for inspiration? Now, you don't have to copy it exactly. You know, now this one doesn't have any feathers on it, but I'm gonna put a feather on it. But you know, look, she gives you all kinds of feathers to draw here, if you don't know how to draw a feather. But look, there's fruit, berries, and she gives you a blank page to, you know, acorns, ferns, and but not any of this can inspire you. There's trees and nests and. You know, it's when it says 20 ways to draw a tree, it's not just trees. It's all kinds of things from nature. Okay, and she's got, I don't know how many, Colleen's probably already gone. Colleen has all these books. I think there's like 10 or 15, maybe 20 of these books. How to draw a whatever, a flower, a tree. There's all kinds of things, but it's not just the tree. It's all kinds of things in there. But anyway, you know, you can take these and just play with them, you know, or just sketch and doodle on them. I'll draw, and I don't normally draw with Sharpie pens. I do it a lot here, so it shows up on camera. But, you know, you could do, let me see, let me try to find a bright pink Sharpie or something. Around here
here somewhere. I gave a lot of it to Pam. But, oh, I could use a pasta paint pen. But Sharpies on acrylic paint is not good. Just saying. They'll dry out real quick. But, you know, if you just want to do a little bit, you can, you know, do a little bit. And I don't even know how old some of these are. That one's dried out. So I need to go through all these. Cam, this is like Cam's drawer when he comes because it's the closest thing I have to Copics because I don't have Copics and he loves Copics. So I let him play in the Sharpie drawer. But for the sake of this, let me just use a white Posca pen. I think that might, well, that may not show up on that one. Here, let's go with this one. But I got all kinds of different things going on. But we'll just draw a feather on here. I tried blind contouring. Yeah, we, you know, there's all kinds of... I think the best book, if you're just, especially if you're just kind of starting out, well, even if you're not just starting out, is Drawing on the Right Side of the Brain. Betty Edwards. That book will help you. What a few coming across. That book will help you with so many things. I remember it was like, I was probably back in the early 80s. Hang on, there's Hubster. Hey, I'm still streaming. Can I call you back? Okay, well, I do need that mailed. All right. I'll talk to you later. Okay. All right, so he's questioning something I wanted to mail. He goes, did you know that this box costs this? So, anyway, he's usually good about not caring. But, you know, sometimes they get expensive. International gets crazy, but, you know, anyway. So I'm just going to draw this feather here. What paint marker would you use on acrylics? What paint marker? Well, this is the only paint marker I have, the Posca white. Usually if I want paint on acrylic, I'll paint with a brush. So I don't really use many paint pens. I'll use black ink with a brush or a calligraphy pen, or I paint with a brush. This is the only paint pen. I might have a couple of really old gold and silver ones, you know, or something like that. I might have a couple, but I haven't used them in years. This white one, though, I love the white Posca pen. Other than this one, I would say Posca pens. I know there's the Sharpie. I've used the white Sharpie, the poster, and the oil base, but I'm not really a paint pen gal. I'm more just acrylic paint. But I would recommend Posca for sure, the brand Posca, and you can get them. I think Eileen and Jean got them some sets on Amazon. You can get them, you can get quite a few of them at Jet Pens, but Posca. These are great. So I'm just going to add a few little weird little feather bits kind of coming off there. There we go. Nothing that ever happens. Okay, something. I'm out of that loop. I answered the phone and got out of the conversation there. If anybody else wants to recommend any kind of paint pens other than Posca, chime in. Posca. Okay, so there we go. I just wanted to give you all some ideas for these toward the back. Don't have as much done. There's a few because I went to the back, you know. You want to go front to back if you can. This is just some ink. You can use your,
Yeah, you're distressing. So let me grab one here. So when you write on your pages, I would recommend a pen. Yeah, use a gel pen or a Bic. If you're on acrylic, let's just say if you're on acrylic paint, your Sharpies are gonna go dry quick. The Poscas, the one Posca I have, I've not had any problem writing with these pens on acrylic. But if you're going to do journaling, I would recommend like a Bic. You know, a Bic, just a plain old Bic. I think they're called Biros internationally. I don't know if that helps. Okay, so these are just, but look. So you can just do this. Look. Just to make some. If you just want to cover some of the. Just rub your ink pad over the whole thing for a distressed look. the Molotov paint pens. Yeah, there's those. There's all kinds of brands. I just don't use them. I don't use paint pens except, you know, occasionally a silver, a gold, a bronze, a white, you know, for something special. But I'm not journal with them. The Posca ones are acrylic paint, so they're perfect for top layers. Thanks, Jean. Jean's got a couple of, she's got a set or two of them. So, yeah. But there's always somebody here that's tried everything at one point or another. Trust me. Someone can answer your question. The Bic brush markers will work on top of Posca also and have a fine marker, great for journaling. So Jean's tried that too. Yeah, the Montanas, that's the other one I've heard of too. But I just don't, I'm just not a paint, I'm just a paint person with a brush for the most part. If I'm journaling, that's the other thing about my art journals, guys. My art journals are for this kind of thing, or my art journals, like my collage journals, you know, the ones that I'd show all the time where I do, grab this one, you know, the collage-y, you know, the more finished pages like these, this kind of thing, where it's my mixed media collage journals. I very rarely write in any of these. If I want to write things, I write them in my Moleskinas or other journaling journals. My writing journals are, for the most part, separate from my art journals. I know a lot of people do both together, but I just don't. That's just me. Nothing wrong with either way. So that came out. Bic brush pens are great on top of pages, including acrylic. Bic brush pens work great on top of pages, including acrylic, is what Jean was trying to say. Poscas make a fine marker, great for adding writing. Yeah, Jean does, she'll write on her art journal pages. Quotes and other things. Music lyrics. But I don't write on them. Yeah, well, trust me. I know Island Girl says, I don't want to go cray-cray with purchasing. Oh, trust me. You're here. You're cray-cray. Just saying. But no, I totally get what you mean. Yeah. I totally get what you mean. I don't use the, this is the only, yeah, I know what you're, Lindsay's asking about the big Mama Jamba Poscas. Yeah, I haven't used those. But I'm just going to do a quick slow flip here just so, yeah. But these are finished and varnished, okay? This book is my finished varnished pages. And I use the Ceram Coat, Delta Ceram Coat Exterior Interior Gloss Varnish. And they don't stick your pages together as long as they're dry. Make sure it's dry before you try to close the book on some varnish. Okay, so go ahead. Any other, ask some more questions and I'll repeat the questions. And so if anybody has, don't let the enablers get you. Rain. Nice try, Rain. Rain saying, don't let the enablers get you. If you're here, you've done been got. Too late. Yeah, Angie, too late. I gotta take a sip of coffee. Right, Lynn? So anyway, guys, so this is what the pages that are completed look like. The ones that I'm showing you in these art in the magazine journals are for me just ways to play when I don't feel like doing anything, but I want to just, you know, and that's rare that I don't feel like doing anything because I'm always so busy doing something. And if you've ever had a job where you had to be creative, you know, I was a visual merchandiser where, you know, we had to decorate stores. You had to be creative every day. You didn't get a choice. You came to work. You did your creative work. And anybody that's been in any kind of a creative field, you know, I did a cross-stitch designing for a company back in the 80s, you know, drawing the sketches and the animals for, you know, to be turned into cross-stitch designs. Anytime you've had any kind of job where you've had to be creative, you just do it because you have to. You're getting paid to do it. Well, you're moving, Sarah. You got other priorities. But, you know, I think that most creativity and most inspiration, and I say it all the time, it's in your butt. Your creativity and your inspiration, for the most part, is in your butt. You sit down, you pick up a pencil or a pen or the paint or the markers or the whatever, and you just start on something, even if it's just doodling in a magazine journal or a sketchbook. You just start. And then, of course, you know, I do my commission portrait, people portraits. You know, now when you're by the something like that, that you have all, you know, you're always developing your skills, of course. As you know, every time you pick up a pencil and you move into the net, you know, into a doing something, you're always going to get better and better at it. But you're also, when you've done something for so long, like color pencil or whatever it is you do, you start developing your skills, and it's not inspiration so much. It's you just know you're going to draw the picture, you're going to sketch it out, you're going to start, like I show how I do, you know, that I map it out with white pencil. You know, I start shading doing the highlights. And so you have a little, like, I don't want to call it a routine, but when you do those kind of things all the time, you already know what you're doing. It's not like I have to think, sit down. I did have to kind of plan out the two, you know, the grandpa pictures. I wanted two on the thing. So, you know, I decided where, you know, how I wanted them and the composition and that kind of thing. You know, did I want to use paint on the hat? How did I want to do the plaid on the shirt? That sort of thing. You can have a little bit of planning, but it's not like you got to wait for, you know, the skies to open up and a light beam to come down on you before you pick up a pencil and start drawing a portrait. So, what did Karen say? So anyway, these are just some of the ones that I've done in the, and these are from 2013, this book. This, you know, and I haven't finished. I'd like to finish this book, but will I finish this book? Maybe, maybe not. But I still love it, whether I completely finish it or not. So, anyway, guys, I hope y'all you know. Got any more questions? I don't know if y'all got any other projects or anything. Is Carrie going to stream? I know Jean can't, but I'm going to run out of time here in about 10 minutes. So if you have any more questions or anything. And these kind of surrealistic type collage paintings, mixed media that I do, I'm not, you know, I'm not saying you can just sit down and whip one of these out, you know, but after you've done hundreds of them, you can probably do them a little faster, you know. But you just got to keep working at it. You got to keep at it. Thanks, Lindsay Whimsy. I try and take a quick nap. Oh, you're going to take a nap first. Okay, Gary. Well, this segment, I mean, if I had another project to, you know, to do, I might do something else. But I've kind of exhausted the magazine journal idea. I've shown my happy mail. So anyway, guys, this is just a couple of magazines glued together, cover to cover, from the, you know, from the back to front. Glue a couple together, cover it with some scrapbook paper or something, and then just, you know, start throwing some paint in there and try to match or not. It's totally up to you what you do with them. But you can at least, I don't use any spray varnishes. I use the Delta Ceram Coat Exterior Interior Gloss Varnish. I use these on, when I do varnish, not this one, when I do varnish a mixed media collage, whether it's in the art journal or if it's the art cards, this is what I used. Get out my coloring book. I did show earlier, I don't know if you were here, Jeannie, I did show some of the coloring books that I have to finish, or the page that I want to finish in the color book, not the whole color book. I don't know that I'll ever finish a whole color book. But, and then this is the new one that I just got Saturday. Have you worked in your art scroll? I haven't worked in the art scroll, well, since the last time you guys saw me work in the art scroll, the animal scroll, yeah. I have a, and that, for those of y'all that ask, is a big roll. It's just a big roll of the shipping paper that you can get for like $3 for 30 feet or something like that. And you can either, I have one that I've cut in half and one that's full size. And that's where I usually do my animals. I do a lot of animal drawings in that for just show y'all how to draw animals. Yeah, chat's been scrolling pretty quick, Jeannie. So, but anyway, if y'all follow me on Twitter and Instagram, it's InkyWell, InkiWell. I try to post most of my, you know, finished pieces, and sometimes even not finished. If we get close to finishing here, you know, I'll either post it almost finished or the finished ones there. Because sometimes we don't have time to finish here, even in a 3-hour segment. And then I also have on Facebook, Dee Dee Willingham. You can go to my albums. You got to go to photos and then albums. And if you don't follow me, most of my albums are public. So you can see my color book pages. You can see my Gold Rush drawings. You can see sketchy drawings. You can see, you know, there's quite a bit of stuff that are in albums. I really need to make an animal portrait album, all just animal portraits. Make an album for that on Facebook. That's something I should probably do. Let me write that down. Make a separate album for animal portraits. Animal portraits. Album. And my enabler friends. You're going to go to a craft garage sale. Oh, one of your friends is having a craft garage sale. Ah.
Could you do a metallic colorbook page like you did the steampunk page? Well, you could. I think I did that Mountain Dreamer. I think I did a big chunk of that. Go look in my color book in the on YouTube in the playlist and color book playlist. I think I did color a lot of that on a show.
Yeah, if you're talking, so she's asking about where's the book? She's talking about this one.
I did, I think I colored quite a bit of this on a show. It's just metallic gel pens, and then the red sparkly bits are stickles. Thanks, Julie Topaz. Thank you. Thank you, Melvie. So, yeah, I'm pretty sure. Now, I don't know that it's come finished from start to finish, but I do show how I did some of it, I think. I'm pretty sure. This is the only page that I've done in this book, so. You did that page for. So I did. Yeah, that's right, Terry. You're right. Terry said I did that page for her. Yeah, other than the stickles, I think, and finishing up some of the metallic, I did do this on a show. So yeah. Yep, Terry Troubles page. That's right. Okay, guys. Well, y'all be looking for Carrie. If y'all don't follow I Carrie Love, she'll tweet out if she streams later. And hey, Sammy Jammy, thank you. Hey, Chinder. Anybody else? Denise. And let me see who else I might have missed. Barry. Thanks everybody for being here. Artsy blessings. I know I've missed people coming and going. Hey, 3G. Buff. Who else did I miss? Diamante and Denise. And I think I said hi to Marie. Embers Rose. Cagefish Cat. I'm just scrolling to see who I might have missed. Lisa Kwai, thanks guys for being here. McCarroll, the Pat, Pam and Pat, Sarah and Sand Pat, Sharon. Hey Sharon, Sharon L. It's been a while since I've seen you. And there's Sherry, Madam Secretary. Ah, and the Terrys and the Trina. Thanks everybody. So y'all have a great afternoon, and I'll try to stream later in the week, but I don't know when yet, because depending on what I do with Cam and Boo. All right, guys, y'all have a good afternoon. Bye.